Hey guys, welcome back to part 10 of my Grim Dawn Hardcore Druid playthrough. Today we'll be starting Act 5 of Ashes of Melmoth, so let's get started. So as you can see, I'm level 65 and I've been doing a bit of leveling off camera. I've got a new skill, I've got Savagery. So I use that to stack savagery against bosses, which gives me lightning damage. I've also got full 55 out of 55 devotions. I took Ultos, and then I went for the owl for the extra energy, the reduced energy cost, and then I went for the crown, Rowan's crown, the last two. But I'll probably need to redo my devotions at some point. Okay, so off camera I killed Bane Gargoth for Kaiman's Chosen, and I also retrieved the Eye of Korvac for Kaiman's Chosen. I then completed the quest for the Shrine of Mogdrogon, which gave me an extra devotion point. Okay, so today we're going to start Act 5 of Ashes of Melmoth. So let's head to Burwich. So just head north from Burwich village until you get to the barrier. Here we are. I'll just click this and purge the barrier. This leads on to Act 5. Okay, so we're just going to head north through Gloomwald until we get to the rift, then we'll head north again until we get to Caraxes. There we go, get the rift. Okay, just keep heading north. More meat for the stew. And somewhere around here is Garrett Torvin, who we have to rescue. There he is. Our first Ogden Bloom, the first of many. Okay, so just speak to this
please
guy here.
Please just leave me.
There we go. Okay, so head north.
You dare come. You dare come here.
Now get the rift here, Gloomwald Crossing. Keep following around the path here.
I will not be.
So you're walking in blooms. Nice. Okay, so up here is the Den of Caraxes, which we need to get his heart, so we can go to the coven. There we go. So I just head out. Okay, so we're heading to the coven. Wow, we took a lot of damage there. We'll take that monster infrequent. Okay, keep heading down and east.
I will devour your
heart. And here we are. Let's get the rift here. Now I can hand in that heart.
Whatever it is you think you're doing, interest. If you seek a path to Ulgrim, you say. What you ask, I care not.
Okay, so now we have to go to Barrowhome. We'll just get some quests whilst we're here. Lore notes. Now here's the witch that we rescued in Act 3, Act 4, all the way back then, Ralia. Speak to her. There There we go. Get a nice bit of XP and cover and reputation. Okay, speak to this guy. Okay, now let's head east to Jinaxia's den. I'm gonna kill some mobs on the way. We need a leaf mane, alpha horn, and venom gaze bile. We'll get them here, hopefully. Hey guys, I'm back. It's the next day, so let's kill Jinaxia. Okay, so let's head out the way we came. And we're going to head north to the Ogden Bog Rift. Then we're going to kill Sylvaria. Okay, get the rift. Now we're gonna head north until we get to Silvaria. So just head east from here. Now go up these steps here and you'll see an entrance. You don't need to go in there just yet. So keep heading down across here. And this is one of the spawn points for the cave where Silvaria is. She's not here today, so let's go and find her. I think we'll find the witches first. Level 66, nice. Here we are, here's Silvaria. So just look for a cave that isn't marked on the minimap. It's in this general area of Odenbog. So let's go in here. Some nice patterns there, nice blueprint. just thinking of which skill to put a point in. Then we'll go for the offensive ability, Spirit. There you go. Okay, here's Silvari. Okay, so let's head back out the way we came. So now I have to find the witches. They're in the southwest of this area. Head up here. Here they are. Okay, so now we can head north to Barrowhome and get the rift. There's the rift, and I'll just keep heading east, and we'll speak to Skorv, Tivold, Jordif. And of course we're going to remain friendly with Barrowhome.
Welcome, traveler. I hope the day finds you great fortune. Well, cutting right through the formalities, then. Well, I'm glad you agree. It's true, we...
Yeah, let's speak to Tivold.
A blessed welcome.
So, now we have to restore some wards and rescue some prisoners. Here's one.
He will devour your heart.
Now we just looted a Leafmane Alpha Horn, which we'll need for a quest, so make sure to get it in this area. There's the other ward. Just need one more ward. There it is. Here's the other prisoner. Okay, let's head back. Okay, so I'm going to leave a rift outside the mine because we're going to come back here. So there we go. Head back to Barahelm. Hand in the quest. And now we get the quest to go to the mine.
A blessed well.
So we just have to kill 6 of the pit creepers in this mine. We've already killed 2, which is a good start. Okay, so we've got 6 out of 6. Now head back to Barahoe. And let's hand in this quest and get the fetish. So let's TP back to the coven. And we'll hand in the quests. Make sure to hand in the witch's quest.
You've returned. You chose to negotiate in now forgotten time. The Altar of Ratosh is a rare place in Cairn. Now that you have, ever since the Ugdumbog fetish was... Yes, perfect. Deep beneath Ugdumbog. Good. Perhaps in time you will find her.
Okay. So now we get another quest here, which is an easy quest.
Garadius, at least you are determined.
That was for Genaxia, well. Which we already killed.
One of our
killed.
Own has become tainted. It appears you...
Okay, so let's head back to Barahoe. And we'll rescue Ulgrim. Spoilers. Okay, so head north from here. Okay, so I just click this, use Ulgrim's heirloom, and then it opens a portal on the altar of Vatosh to the Void's Edge. So we're going to go in there now. Okay, so let's find the boss, Eketzul. So just keep heading west and you'll find the path. And now take this portal here. Stash. Let's put some points into Mavens, I think. Okay, so here's the boss. Eketzul. That was easy. Didn't drop anything. Okay, so keep heading up. Thank you. we'll come across an old friend from Act 4. Here he is. Now you have the choice of talking to him or fighting him. I recommend that you talk to him because he's very difficult to fight.
Is that you, Mother? An unfortunate accident, my Emperor Ulgrim. Yes, yes, I think I remember now. To Malmuth, I see.
Okay, so I'll just head up. Keep heading north until you find the portal. There it is on the map. And that's Act 5 done. We're now through to Act 6. So I just speak to Ulgrim.
It's good to... You're right. Oh, to the north is Malmuth. Is that...
Okay, we're going to carry on for a little bit more until we get to the sewers. So just kill all these guys. Okay, let's head to the Malmuth outskirts. Now, there is a shrine down here somewhere, but I'm not going to get it because there's no point. Down here somewhere. Okay, let's head to the rift. Speak to Olgrim.
Well, here we are. Not to worry.
Okay, now we're gonna make our way through the sewers. Down here for a secret chest. One shot chest. Okay, let's enter the sewers. Got some nice shoulders there, I think. Okay, here we are. Okay, speak to this guy.
You better have a damn good reason to be here. Before I assume you're just another... Eh? You and what army? The city's been overrun. Our people are scattered. Dead. As far as I know, we're the last pocket of free people in our once... The Black Legion? They survived the carnage in the capital? I don't know what that means. But if it's...
Speak to Olga.
So, this is what's... Yes, that will suffice to let Creed's troops pour
nice.
Into the city
now
proper.
Honored with the Black Legion.
You will have to make your way to the Candle District...
Okay, so here we are. Okay. Well guys, that's it for today's episode. I think the next episode will be the final one where we start Act 6. And then we'll move on to better things. I'm thinking of trying out the new season, Season 4 of the Community League. But yeah, until then, I appreciate any tips, any comments. Please like and subscribe. But until then, I'll see you.